Hey there, this is Abdul and today we are going to learn how you can get the average colors for your artwork from an image that is the reference photo of your artwork. So without any further delay, let's get going. Before we get started, I want to share with you that we are going to use Photoshop and Illustrator for getting the average colors from the photo. And these are the two softwares that are mostly used by artists to make artwork. So we are going to use just them. Let's just first start with Photoshop. In Adobe Photoshop, you can use two methods to get the exact average of colors. For first method, we are going to get the average sample and then we are going to get an average color from that sample. So let's get into Photoshop. First of all, I would like to thank Krill for giving us this photo that we can use in our example. Krill, great artist from Unsplash. So thank you, Krill. So we are going to get the skin tone from face. We are going to get a sample from face so that we can get a good color for making a perfect skin tone. Okay, so zoom in and let's see, this is the skin. We are going to get a sample from skin, but the light should not affect the skin. So color should be in between the shadows and highlights. That would be not the perfect highlights and not the perfect shadows. So we have to be in between the middle of that thing. We have to get the most resembling color from head. We cannot take sample from this side nor this side. We have to be in the middle of something like this skin. This skin is perfect for getting the sample. So we are going to get the sample where light is affecting minimum. So this skin tone is perfect for getting a perfect sample. We are going to target this skin. So let's select a selection tool, whatever you want to get the selection. I would like to take the lasso tool and select the area that you want to get a sample of. Remember, you don't have to take a sample from shadows. You don't have to take a sample from highlights. You have to be somewhere in the middle. How much area you cover in your sample, that is going to give you most resembling skin tone. So try to get a little extra sample so that we can get the exact color of the skin. So for me, I think this area is perfect and this much will work. After selection, I would like to go in filters and then select the average blur. You have the sample now. So this is the exact skin tone color of the skin. It has got an average color of the skin tone. There is another method for getting a perfect sample, and the other method is more effective than this one, and you can get a sample of highlights and whole of your image. So you don't have to be fixed on a base sample of skin. You can get a sample of everything. You can get a sample color of everything that is on your photo. You will get the color for highlights, for shadows, for hair, everything. Everything will be covered in this just one filter that I'm going to reveal just in a few moments. So how can we approach to that filter? So first of all, what we are going to do is to go into filters, then filter gallery. In the filter gallery, you will see here artistic, and you will get the preview right on the side, and you can minimize the preview also. So what kind of filter will I apply on this? So go into artistic, use this filter, cut out. So what it is going to do, it is going to take the sample and average color of the skin. So you don't have to be worried about a single thing. It's going to do in just one click. This is the highlight area and this is the mid-tone and this is the shadow area. This will create a whole color palette. You don't have to do anything. There are few sliders here. You can play with all of them. If you want more colors, then you can play with all the settings and get more colors than the three of them that you are seeing right now. If you want more colors, increase the number of levels and then you are good to go. How much you increase this number of levels, you will get more colors. What it is doing is taking a sample of colors from your photo, and then it just give you a color that is the average color of the whole area that it is selecting, and then taking an average. So it's doing something like that. So I think this much is better. So once you are ready, you can hit OK. You can get the sample of each color. This method is really effective in getting the perfect colors from your photo. And that is something that makes me feel like home. So it's time for the Illustrator. We are going to go to Illustrator and then get the most of the colors there, as we have done here. We are going to do the same thing in Adobe Illustrator. First of all, bring image in Adobe Illustrator, and what you have to do is to go into Windows. Make sure you have selected the image, and then go to Windows, Image Trace. You have to get the panel of Image Trace. Once the Image Trace panel is available to you, what you have to do is to select this custom, and then presets will be available to you. There's high fidelity photo and low fidelity photo, 3 colors, 16 colors, 6 colors, gray scale, and there are a lot options. Select 16 colors is a good place to be, but still you can change the colors range. There would be a slider that will show you how many colors you want. So it has done most of the part. Let's see. It has taken the sample of the image and gave us a few average colors that are present in our image. But here is a slider of colors. You can decrease the color range or increase it. It's upon you how many colors you want. You can play with this slider. This is going to do a lot better work. Click this eyedropper tool and then select color. I can get the exact color code. This is the average color and this is the color code. This is the simplest way in Adobe Illustrator how you can get the average of colors. You can reuse them in your artwork. So this is it for today's video. I hope you enjoyed it, and if you really did, give us a like and also subscribe to our channel. Smash it or do whatever you want that must be clicked. I'll see you next time. Until then, goodbye. Thank you.